Cattle are the lifeblood of the Maasai tribe in northern Tanzania. Their milk is a critical source of income and nutrition. But these cattle are at risk of a serious disease that can dry up their milk permanently and impact the community's health. The tiny tsetse fly carries a parasite that causes sleeping sickness. It's a zoonotic disease that can affect both people and cattle. The flies thrive here in the woodlands, a place where people also take their cattle to graze because of dramatic changes in the land and water. Fields have become overgrazed, leaving them dry and dusty.
You already have grassland that's severely degraded because it's being too heavily grazed, and then you're having these longer periods of drought more often. And what that means is that you're just losing all your ground cover and it's not getting the chance to recover.
With changes in climate, climate variability, changes in, like, say, drought, but also water scarcity, this has been forcing the Maasai people to migrate even farther and farther, and in sometimes have been encroaching into wildlife areas, and hence exposing themselves and their cattle to diseases which have been dormant for many years in wildlife.
The problem is not only sleeping sickness, but rabies, bacterial infections, and diseases carried by ticks. Yet, these zoonotic diseases do not get much attention.
Diseases of importance are those which affect international trades on livestock. And diseases which does not affect trades, actually they are given less priority. And one of those diseases, they are TRIPS.
These challenges in such vulnerable, remote areas without national or international support are requiring new approaches. The sciences of the flies, the parasites, the environment, water and climate are merging, with the community as a key link in both the research and the solutions.
We're doing the science in a very different way that's much more in partnership with the communities.
Dr. Jakob Aku, District Veterinary Officer of Monduli, is one of the many partners working with the Tanzanian researchers. He's part of a large study, not only here, but across Africa, coordinated by the World Health Organization's Tropical Disease Research Program, called TDR.
My role is to carry the researchers to the field and to interpret the research and the scientific language to the farmers, so that by using my simple language, the Maasai language, we may share co-talks with the researchers.
Data collected by PhD students shows that up to 29% of the flies carry this parasite. But this varies by season and location. Blood samples from cattle that graze in these areas will show how this translates into infection rates. The Maasai have always known they need to move cattle away from grazing areas for a period of time so that the grasses can recover. But with more land taken over by farms, and expanding populations and competition from wildlife, there's less healthy land available. It's a clear example of the interacting effect of climate change and disease risk. This research should help identify the safest areas to take cattle and support new grazing systems.
It's targeted science, if you will, that we're hoping can go more directly into the hands that might actually benefit from it.
This disease could be a re-emerging disease in humans. And therefore it is very timely and it is very important that we are doing this research now at a time when there are no episodes in humans, so that we can combat it very early before it comes again as a big episode.
Results from this study and four others that look at additional diseases like malaria will be finalized at the end of 2016. By starting at the source, they offer a new model of approaching the complicated climate change issues that touch on land use, water, animal, and human health.
You're not going to find sustainable solutions to these kinds of natural resource challenges and these kinds of disease burden challenges unless you're working with the community from the get-go.